Recording here. So for this purpose, we are going to need a specialized hardware that is going to be a wireless adapter.
So oh, I'm going Wi-Fi. To use, okay.
Yeah, Wi-Fi adapter. It looks something like this. Let's go to shopping. What I am going to use, there are a lot of wireless adapters out there to select from. I'm going to use Leox's one. I'll share the link for that as well. Leox's Wi-Fi adapter. Yeah, this is the one. Okay. This is what I'm going to use. So let me share the link in the chat as well. Okay. So let's get back to my VMware. And let's start my Kali Linux. Successfully booted my Kali machine here. So now I'm going to plug in my wireless adapter. Just give me a quick second. Plugged in. It is giving me this option like, do you want to connect this adapter to virtual machine? So I'm saying virtual machine, select the virtual machine here. Click on OK.
Sorry, Jib, I missed it. Where you went to get this USB?
Sorry, this adapter?
Yeah.
I bought it online itself.
Amazon. Okay. It already connected in your machine.
Yeah, now I connected it.
Okay.
It's an external device.
Okay.
I just plugged it in.
Okay.
Okay. So now if I'm going to open my terminal over here, let's do a sudo ifconfig. So now you can see that there's a new interface here that says WLAN 0. That simply means that now I have wireless capabilities with me. Here you can see that I am given this option to connect to Wi-Fi, different Wi-Fis out there.
Just right click, we can list down this Wi-Fi adapter, get list down here.
Yes.
Okay.
So now for this purposes, I'm going to use Aircrack Suite. Okay. When I say Aircrack suit is nothing but, you can say it's a bundle of suit. It's a bundle of different tools. That is AirmonNG. That's one. AeroDumpNG, that's another one.
What is this?
these are different tools which I'm going to use.
These are all for Wi-Fi.
Yes.
Hacking.
Yes, for Wi-Fi hacking. And then AirCrackNG. So let's look into it. So first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this wireless adapter into monitor mode. I need to change this mode to monitor mode. How I'm going to do this thing? I'm going to do this thing using AirMonNG. That is AirMonNG. Oops, just to sudo AirMonNG start WLAN 0. So now what it is going to do is it is going to put my wireless adapter to monitor mode.
Okay.
Yeah. Let me do sudo ifconfig again. And you can see that my adapter settings are now, my name of the adapter has changed from WLAN 0 to WLAN 0 Moon.
System taken as name like this, or you have given in somewhere else this name?
What? This
WLAN, yeah.
This is automatically.
Automatically taken.
Yeah. Okay. I have not assigned this name. This is like by default, the interface name is WLAN 0.
Okay.
Yes. So, okay. That's one thing. Now, there's a command suggestion which is provided to me here. So there are certain processes which are running which can interfere with my process. So I'm going to kill those processes by using this command, that is airmonng check kill. Okay, so the first command that I have used is airmonng start. This is the first command that I have used for putting the wireless adapter to monitor mode. Okay. Let's get back here. So, okay. Now I want to start sniffing for nearby packets. So how will I start? I'm going to start sniffing. Before sniffing, I'm going to go to desktop. I'm going to create a directory here. Let's say Wi-Fi 1, cd Wi-Fi 1. I am inside this directory. Now I'm going to start sniffing. Sudo aerodump ng hyphen w for writing the packets, whatever packets have been captured, for saving them into a file. So I'm going to use let's say ch is my output file name. Okay. And followed by your interface name, that is WLAN 0 Moon. So this is the command which I'm using for capturing the packets. Let's press enter and you will see that packet capture has been started now. Okay, so I have some output on my screen. Now let's try to understand this output. Okay.
Okay.
I have something like ESSID, BSSID, ENCCH. Okay. Let's try to understand this thing. So the first one is your ESSID. What is ESSID? ESSID basically means the name of your router, you can say. Okay. The name of your access point.
That okay.
is ESSID. Okay. it's like the, it is the name that you have provided to your Wi-Fi. That's one thing. Now there is something known as BSSID. So can you see what BSSID means? Can you see, can you try to infer something out of this output that you can see?
Yeah.
So what is BSSID then? So BSSID is basically the MAC address of your target router. That is
MAC address. Okay.
Yes.
That it is comes actually 4-digit colon 4-digit like that, right?
It's MAC address. MAC address is a 48-bit hexadecimal address. Okay. And you can see here that these are 48 bits. Okay. These are your hexadecimal format. There are going to be 6 octets here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 octets in hexadecimal format.
So this MAC address from router MAC address, huh?
Yes. That's router MAC address.
Where that adapter installed?
Yeah, adapter installed. Sorry.
You plug that adapter in your machine.
Yes.
Router for some other broadband. Still, I'm not getting clear on this concept.
It's let's not try to complicate it. Just think it in a simple way. Mm-hmm. You have your laptop.
Yeah.
And when you try to connect to Wi-Fi, there are a lot of Wi-Fi's available, right?
Yeah.
Your Wi-Fi and your neighbor's Wi-Fi.
Right. Yeah.
So when I say you are trying to connect to your Wi-Fi, basically in your system, in your laptop, in your mobile phone, you have that Wi-Fi adapter inbuilt. That's an inbuilt functionality.
Yeah.
Okay. In this VMware, in my system, I do not have it inbuilt. So okay. That's why I'm just using that external adapter. Nothing
okay.
else.
Okay.
If you are it's like if you are using Windows operating system okay. as your host. If you are going to install Kali Linux as your host okay. Operating system in your Windows, then you are not going to need that wireless adapter.
Okay.
Because it is going to be pre-installed in your hardware. There's a wireless adapter inbuilt in your laptops.
Okay.
That's why you are able to connect to any Wi-Fi without any adapter, right? Like this design here. So you can see the names which are visible here are also the names which are visible here, right?
More than that also getting listed here.
Yeah. So there are more names visible here because probably some of them are not being shown there, okay. but they are being visible here. Okay. Now BSSID is your MAC address, right? And CH is for channel. There okay. are various channels on which an access point can work. Okay. Generally, a channel value is going to range from up to the number 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Okay.
And there's going to be something known as encryption here. So encryption basically tells you what kind of security mechanism is applied here.
Okay.
There are three types out there. One is WEP, another one is WPA, and another one is WPA2. Okay, this is 2. So WPA2 is the latest one that is going to be available in most of the latest devices. Okay. WEP stands for Wired Equivalent Privacy. That is the oldest one out there. Okay. And WPA basically stands for Wi-Fi Protected Access. Okay. WPA is for Wi-Fi Protected Access 2. WEP came in the year 2000, not 2000, it came in the year 1997. WPA2 came in the year 2004. Till today, we use WPA2. Okay. And WPA1 came in the year 2003. It lasted for only 1 year. These are just your security mechanism that are being implemented, okay?
Okay.
So nowadays, all of these devices which are manufactured after the year 2004, they are going to be implemented with WPA2s. Okay. Okay. So what I need to do here is I need to, let me just stop this packet capture here. Just stop it. Okay. There is something known as WPA.
Any radius within this radius, we can get this Wi-Fi connection details.
Yes. Oh. Right. That depends upon your antenna, right?
Yeah. Okay.
So as I am using this normal Leoxid adapter, mm-hmm. So it is going to have small range, okay, probably from 50 to 100 meters, you can say, okay. If I am going to use some more expensive adapter, which is going to have some better antenna, which is able to capture more traffic, something like that. So that would be having better range, okay. So that depends upon your antenna, like what kind of range is going to be available. Okay, so first of all, let's understand what is WPA three-way handshake. Oh, sorry, not three-way, it's four-way handshake. Okay. So let's create a device here. There's a device here. Just like this. There's a router here. Okay. So the first step in this four-way handshake is your the step of broadcasting the nouns. Okay. So what router is going to do is, first of all, router is going to broadcast the nouns everywhere. Okay. Why? So nouns is nothing but you can say it's a formal term, formal way of referring to a packet. That is nouns. Okay. It's just a formal way of referring to some packet. So router is continuously shouting and saying that, okay, I exist. Just telling that I exist. If you want to connect, you can connect to me. Okay. That is what router is doing. So when I see a lot of options available here, while I'm trying to connect to any access point, why am I able to see these options here? Because these routers are shouting that, okay, we exist. You can connect to us. Okay. That is your first step. So routers broadcast the nouns is, then there is from your client reply to the nouns. Okay. This reply is sent when you click on that connect button, when you select the Wi-Fi and you click on that connect button that I want to connect to this Wi-Fi. Okay. So what you are trying to do there is you are trying to send a reply to that nouns. Okay. Right. So this is something Like when I just click here and click on connect,
yeah,
that is reply to the nouns.
Okay.
Okay. Now comes your third step. So now the router is going to say, router is going to send you the message of authentication. A message of authentication is going to be sent from the router to your client. Like, what is message of authentication? So it is just a pop-up asking you to enter the password. That is message of authentication. When you try to connect to a Wi-Fi, it is going to ask you to enter a key, right? Enter a password.
Yeah.
So that is message of authentication, basically.
Okay.
Now what client is going to do after this is, client is going to send the key, or you can say password or passphrase. Okay. Passphrase to the router. So this is your fourth step in this four-way handshake. When you try to enter the key and click on send or connect, that's your the reply to the authentication. Okay, acknowledgement to that authentication. These four steps are clear?
Yeah.
Okay, great. So now what happens is, whatever we are doing is, and the packet capturing stuff, we are trying to capture this thing, this four-way handshake. Okay, because in this four-way handshake, in the last, you are going to see that there's a key which is going to be captured. Okay, we want to capture the key, that's first thing, and then we want to crack the key, that's the second thing.
Okay.
So let's get back, clear everything.
So all this process, to connect Wi-Fi, right? So giving authentication, connect, password, everything.
Yes. So this is
these are four-way handshake.
Yes. This is something which is happening behind the scenes.
Okay.
User is not aware of all this stuff. Okay. Okay. So let's pick up my target here. Let's say my target is, let's say City Broadband. This is my target. Okay. And it is working on channel number 11. Okay. So let's do sudo airborne ng. Stop. WLAN 0 mon. Start WLAN 0 followed by your channel number. I mentioned the channel. Okay. Now let's go back to my desktop directory. Wi-Fi 1. Sudo aerodump ng hyphen hyphen help. Let's open the help menu. Okay. So hyphen hyphen channel. So what I'm going to do is sudo. Let's open another tab here. Sudo aerodump ng hyphen w for writing the output in a file. Let's call it as Kali. Okay. And followed by hyphen hyphen channel, CHANNEL. I want to capture the traffic on channel 11. Okay. And followed by your interface name. Now it is basically capturing the traffic on channel 11 only. Okay. Now I'm basically waiting for a handshake to appear here. Okay. So either I can just sit out here and just wait passively for a handshake to appear here, or what I can do is I can try performing a deauthentication attack. Okay. So for performing a deauthentication attack, what I need to do is, what I'm going to do here is sudo air replay ng hyphen hyphen deauth 0 hyphen a. Hyphen a is for target MAC address. So target is city broadband. The MAC address is this. Just copy this, paste it here, and I can just press enter. Okay, I forgot to mention the interface here, WLAN 0 MON. Yeah. So what you can see here is I have started the deauthentication attack. So what does deauthentication attack means? Deauthentication attack basically means that I am trying to attack the access point, I'm trying to attack the router, and I'm trying to disconnect all the devices which are connected to that router.
Okay.
That's what I'm trying to do here. So let it run for a while. So I'm going to just keep this thing running till I can see a handshake being captured here. Okay. So let me just stop it and check it out. Okay. Let's try to run this thing again. It says no BSSID available. Maybe the router went down. Maybe it's now switched off. Let me just see. It is here. And the BSSID is okay. We have more than one city broadband here. Okay. It is there. Let's try to do it again.
This command to make the router down, is it?
This command is going to disconnect all the devices which are connected to the router.
Okay. Disconnect all the devices. Okay.
Yeah. So that then users, all those users try to connect back to the router and will be able to capture a handshake. Okay. We just ran this command here. Okay. We have already executed this command. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to see if I have captured anything there. CD desktop Wi-Fi 1 external LS. Second time I started the capture with the name of Kali. Let's try to crack the handshake using aircrack. Sudo aircrack ng hyphen w for word list user.
So these are the basic steps to hack the Wi-Fi credential, no? Or?
Yes. These are the standard steps that you need to follow.
Okay.
Okay. I cannot see any handshake as of now. me just mention 8 here. Okay, so the handshake is not captured as of now. So actually this is not a guaranteed method. Okay. It's like sometimes it takes minutes, sometimes it takes hours, and sometimes it can even take days for getting the handshake. Okay. So it depends from scenario to scenario. If you are able to get a handshake, you will be able to crack it.
Okay.
It says no such BSS ID available. Okay, let's try to target the TP link 380A. Yes, so we are doing a de-auth attack here. So I can see here a WPA handshake has been captured. Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Now let's try to crack it. Okay, where did I save the output? I do not know. Yeah, here I have saved the output. Let's try to run sudo aircrackng-w. The save word list rocket.txt. And I have a handshake being captured here. So let's select the fourth option and press enter. Let's try to run this command again. aircrackng-w user share word list rocket.txt. select the file that is fifth one, I believe. Yeah, fifth option. I selected the fifth option, and now here you can see that it has started cracking the password. Okay, if a valid combination is going to be found, it's going to show me the password.
Okay.
So again, there is no 100% guarantee that you would be able to, first of all, get the handshake, and then second of all, you would be able to crack it or not. Okay, that is also conditional.
Okay.
So if the word, if the password which is being used that is present in my word list, then I would be able to find the password. I would be able to crack the password. Otherwise, not. So here you can see that it is going to take a lot of time. Okay, sometimes you will get the answer in few minutes, sometimes it can even take hours and days to crack the password. Okay, I also have another handshake capture file. Let me just show you. Sudo aircrackng-w user share word list rockero.txt followed by my path wifi collie.cap. I have a handshake here as well. And you can see here there's a handshake. Let me try to select this option 16. Try to crack it. And here you can see that it says key found. And the key is
123456789.
Password. It was an easy pass. I was able to find it very quickly.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So the time varies upon the strength of the password.
What is this tool actually?
What is this?
Tool or command you have changed?
The command that I have used. So here are the sequence of commands that I have used.
Okay.
First two commands I have mentioned in the blue. Now I'm writing the last two commands. That is sudo.
No, we are getting the keys very fast, right? So for that, same command or different command?
Same command.
Same.
That depends upon it, like what kind of password has been selected by the target.
Okay.
Okay. Sudo air replay ng -dauth 0-a target VSSID here WLAN 0 moon. That's the command for air replay. Then air crack ng -w user share word list rocky.txt followed by your file name kali1 or kali.cap. Okay, so these are the commands which I have used to perform these steps. Okay. Right. Any doubt? Yeah, I'm not able to hear you properly.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah, no doubt here. Somewhat, some extent, I understood how that works.
Yeah.
The logical part I understand.
Right. See, the more would be better. It is going to be more clear once you try it by yourself. Okay. Then it would be
but
more.
But to try myself, I have to install that
adapter.
Adapter, right?
Okay. Yeah, you need to purchase that adapter. And then you will be ready to go.
And for application, web application, PT, right? For that, will this Wi-Fi will it cover or it will not cover?
No, Wi-Fi is not covered.
Totally different, right?
Yeah. Wi-Fi is totally Wi-Fi different. Wi-Fi in itself is so vast. Let me just tell you this thing that we have covered, as we are trying to cover it in CH. It is very brief, high-level overview. If I talk about in-depth, there's a certification known as OSWP.
Okay.
Offensive Security Certified Wireless Professional. Okay.
Oh.
Or you can say Wi-Fi Kung Fu, something like that. Okay. Wireless attacks. So it's like a very in-depth, dedicated about Wi-Fi PT. Skills needed to audit and secure wireless devices. Okay. That's the thing here.
And for web application PT, how the openings in outside
I lost you from that point.
How the openings in outside actually job openings.
Okay, job openings for web application penetration testing.
Yeah,
there are a lot of openings in web application penetration testing. It's like something that it's like burning topic nowadays.
Is there any prerequisite experiment, hands-on experiment, anything?
Hands-on?
Hands-on experiment, what is that? Experience is required as mandatory?
See, most of the times experience is definitely a good add-on. Okay, if you have some experience as a penetration testing profile, but if you do not have that, you can just start. You can just try to go for some web application penetration testing specific certification. Then you can right away go for the job as a web app pen tester.
How can Nano clear the interviews and all if we have any technically anything that we can clear and if you complete a certification, any course that we can clear it?
The web application penetration testing interview.
Interviews. Say for example, if I taking classes and getting somewhat training, okay, getting certification, based on that, will it possible I can clear the interview?
Yes, definitely.
Okay.
Definitely.